那我再说一下吧，这个，哎呦，前面的让他到时再给我们看版式。
Hello, I'm back.
Shanashi, could you show that the whiteboard? Because I have not recorded just now, so maybe you can share that whiteboard. I can explain briefly again.
Yeah.
Maybe could you share that? Could you go back to that? Sorry, it's not this page, the other page, so that you can tell them which sutra is it, because I forgot to record just now.
Okay, so you want me to share the Sashoti Sutra?
Oh, yes.
Okay, is it this one?
Sorry.
Yes, I did.
Maybe you can read that to the sutra we are learning. Maybe.
Okay, this is Sashoti.
这就是我们的
Okay.
Shashchodi 这句经言，是我们要学的这个叫 Shashchodi 经言。这个 Shashchodi is what we are learning, right?
Yeah, such Choti Sutra we are going to learn.
OK，Shashchodi 这个经言是我们是这样学的。然后这个里边的有一个例子，So what is the example, of it? The
Example is
For
touch
you,
Shivaha. There is only one example.
Dutch Shivaha 老师，这个鼠标点的 Dutch Shivaha 就是我们要学的例子，它的意思就是指那个非常的吉祥殊胜。And then, could you show that whiteboard? Thank you.
Yeah, I'm going to show that.
然后呢，这个就是我们的这个老师的例子，就是这个。来拍一下啊，就是它的例子就是这个 dud，就是这个 dud dud 这个 dud 的 tava，could you read that that dachi
Touch Shivaha. Touch Shivaha.
dachi vaha？So the first one is dash，could you read the first one then second one？The first one。
First one is Touch Shivaha. Touch Shivaha.
Dutch Chivaha 第一个例子，then the second one，
Touch Shivaha.
Dutch Chivaha 这就是第二个的读音。那然后呢，我们这个 Dutch Chivaha 把它这个拆开来，也就是 Dutch 跟 Chivaha。那这个 Dutch 的话，这个第一个 Dutch 根据这个 Harrison 的辅音的这个我们经言的第一句话，这个 the 就会变成 j。这个 jud 的话，就是我们的这个，等一下，再看一下，确认一下。这个
Could
jud 的
I
话，
repeat
是
it?
我们的这个上颚的 j，就是 judge 的 j，就这个 dud 这个 d 会变成 j。然后呢，就是，这是第一步。那然后呢，第二步的话是，我们这句经言会跟大家来。说明的经验会解释的，就是我们 shivaha 的这个上颚的 sh 会变成这个 jch 上颚的 ch，就为什么这个上颚的 sh 会变成上颚的 ch 呢？那我们会来学习这句经验。Yes, Achanaji。
Yeah. Okay. So we will see now that how this sha is optionally changed into cha.
那我们会来看一下这个 sh 上颚的 sh 怎么会变成这个可选择性的变成这个 ch，就是这个 jch 的这个 ch。 怎么会变成的？变成的？
Are we ready?
那准备好了吗？Yes。
So we will get back to Akshar Sadhana upon such choti and we will then discuss it.
那我们先回到这个经验，我们来读一下，然后我们再来解释。
So say all of you, shas choti.
Shashchodi,
Jaya
Chaya
Bharasya.
Havarasya,
Shastya.
Shastya,
Chovati. Chovati.
Chovati.
So let's understand the essence of this sutra and how does it apply on Tat Shivaha.
那我们来看一下这句经言内涵，它是怎么运用的？
The sutra says, let me explain the sutra now.
我来跟大家解释一下这句经言的意思内涵。
The sutra says, when the last letter, okay, let me write it down. When the last letter of the Purva Pada is from Jhanya Pratyahara, is from Jhanya Pratyahar and the first letter of the Uttara Pada is Talavyasha and after Talavyasha the letters of At Pratyahar are after. The letters of At Pratyahara are after. In that case, the Talavyasa will be optionally converted into Cha.
So you could you repeat what do you mean by the other is after? Other after means what?
At is a Pratyahara. Wait, Michelle, see here. When the last letter of the Purva Pada is from Jhanya Pratyahara,
Yes.
after
Yes.
that Talavyasa comes, and after Talavyasa, the letters of At Pratyahara comes. Then in that case, optionally this Sha will be converted into Cha. Now let's understand this in the context of Tat Shivaha. Here
No.
in Tat Shivaha, please understand it. You first understand, then you'll be able to explain.
Okay,
Here
got it.
in this Tat Shivaha, the Cha is from Chaya Pratyahara. After Chaya Pratyahara, the Sha has come into picture. And after Sha, Talavisha come into picture. And after Talavisha, E, which is the part of At Pratyahara, is after. In Shiva, it is Sha plus E. You know, E is after, which is the part of At Pratyahara. That is why this Sha is optionally converted into Cha, which is Tat Shivaha.
But that E is I mean E is not after, it's like before the sh.
Nana, where are you? See, like she, when we take the split version of the she, it is Sha plus Rashva E.
Oh, this is Russian E. Russian E is before
Rashva E is placed before Rashva and Sha and Rashva E. So Sha comes first and E is coming later on. Sha plus E is converted
So
into
what
Chi.
is the D? Diga E is after, because Diga E. If this Diga
Michelle,
E.
you are forgetting. See,
Yeah, forgetting.
after a consonant, when a verb comes, that verb is merged into consonant. Like sha plus e becomes she. If e will come first, it would be ish. It would be ish. Okay? Ish. So that is not the case. In Shiva, it is the split version of Shiva is sha plus e plus va plus a. That is Shiva. So,
Yeah.
but in Shiva, first of all, the sha has come, and e is the part of at pratyaha.
How can you write that? Could you write that if the E is not Russia's diga? How can you write it? Diga E
Okay.
plus.
Okay, let me open the new page.
Maybe you can just write above that Russia she.
I'm writing in the new page.
Okay.
So if Dirgha Shi is to be written, it will look like this. It is Sha plus Dirgha E. Sha, Sha plus Dirgha E. Thereby Shi. When it comes to Shi, it will be written like this. Shiva. So here in this Shiva, it is Sha plus E is Shi. Got it, Michelle?
Yes，就是 OK，Yeah，Maybe、okay, you can go，就是大家首先
Now we
看
can
这个
repeat those conditions. No, you
，So
have to repeat those conditions to me first.
OK，OK，So、okay, okay. first the one the last letter of the poor brother is from Chaya Badeha，right? So
Very
the last
good.
letter of the poor brother is from Chaya Badeha, which is that Jha is from the Chaya Badeha Jha. Right, then the first letter of the Buddha Buddha is like sha,
Talavesha, very
Talavesha, and that after the Talavesha the Ud the Padyaha Ud, is that Ud or Ad?
Ad, not Uttar. Ad
Ad.
Pratyahar comes. So E is the part of Ad Pratyahar.
Yes, E is ad, is part of the ad padyaha.
Pratyaha.
Is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's like Maheshwara Sutra number one to
Yes,
number five. Yeah,
Pratyaha.
right.
Ayur Ra Hayavarat.
Yeah,
Hayavarat. Ad Pratyahar includes
yes.
E also.
然后我来给大家再，这样我来涂。群里边发一下，等一下，就蓝的括号，好，大家
Yes,
看一下这
Michelle.
个，yes，我们首先看一下这个是我们的湿婆经年代，还记得吗？就是说大家可以记下，就是说还有这个，就是说那个，我们先看那个。图上的这张图，大家还记得吗？给大家复习一下，就是这个就是 Shivaha 对吧？Shivaha 的这个是 Udaba 的这个 Shivaha。那我们看到这个老师写的这个上面的下面一行 she 就是 she 对吧？下面这个 she 是这个 she，后面跟的是一个 Russia 的 e，然后那个上面那个。上面一行的这个 she 是这个舍牙齿的舍，后面加了一个是，这个第一个的 e，所以是这样写的，大家可以看一下。那就是说，先跟大家讲一下，然后就是说，这个敬业的规则的内涵是这样的：当 udaba 的最后一个字母是来自于 chaya badeha，对吧？chaya badeha。就是 chaya badeha 就是说我是用这个块区里边我是用红色划出来的 chaya badeha 那就是当这个破白的最后一个字母是来自这个 chaya badeha 然后这是第一个条件。那这个 chaya badeha 我们这个今年的这个折就是不是就是在这个 chaya badeha 里边的？然后呢，折。就是这个这，对吧？然后呢，第二个条件是 udaba 的第一个字母是上颚的 sh，然后另外一个条件是这个上颚的 sh 后面跟的字母是来自于 ad 所写的，就是我用蓝色的括号里打蓝色括号的就是 ad 这个缩写里边所含的字母。 那我们这个 e 就是这个在 other 缩写里边的字母，对吧？Yes，是哪些？
OK，
老师，所以我问一下，所以是，所以他这句子的那个 e 是下面那一行那个 e 嘛，对不对？那 下面对
个。
下面那个行的，就也就是说，这个 e 虽然说这个 e 是看起来是写在它的这个，虽然这个 e 看起来是写在它的前面，对吧？是吧？但是它其实是写在它后面的，就是它其实是把它拆开来是写在它后面的。
哦，那是指这个长，那个长音的，还短。
短的音，我现在说的是第二行，she
哦，
的
对
第
对，
二行，
短音，
就是说，
对。
因为第二行的 e 看起来是写在它的前面的，明白吧？
了
但
解，
其实
懂意思。
是跟在它后面的。
那上面那个长的 e 就不算了，对不对？
啊？什么？
上面那第一行那个长的 e 那个那就不算嘛，对不对？应该是指第二行那个短的那
第
个
二
e
行
嘛，
的
对
那个，只是告诉你，如果是长的 e 是这样写的，短的 e 是这样写的。
吧？哦，好，所以应
就
该是
它
只
上面
适
是
用在。
第一个，上面就我们现在例子是第二行的，
OK。
但是上面一行就刚刚帮大家复习一下，就是说如果是长的 e 的话是写在后面的，那短的 e 的话是写在前面的。但是虽然说它这个范文里面写在前面，但其实它是在跟在它后面的，这个意思。
好，
因为这个 e 是在这个 other 缩写里边的，要满足这个几个条件。
Can I proceed?
Yeah.
Again, I'm repeating. When the last letter of the Purva Pada is from Jaya Pratyahar, after that, Talab Visarga comes. That will optionally get converted into tha. When that Talab Visarga is followed with, after Talab Visarga, the letters of At Pratyahar comes.
就是在这个上颚的舌后面，就是出现了这个叫 ud 的这个缩写。
Okay? That is why in Tach Shivaha, the cha is from Jaya Pratyahar. After that, the Talavisa has come. That Talavisa is followed with E, which is the part of At Pratyahar. That is why that cha is optionally converted into cha.
就是再说一遍，就是这个规则是这样的，pub 的最后一个字母它是来自 chaya budha 哈，就是我画红线的这个 chaya budha 哈。那我们这个就是 the 这个 j 就是在这个 chaya budha 里边的这个字母。那第二个条件是 udab 的第一个字母是上颚的 sh，那另外就是上颚的 sh 后面跟的就是这个 ad 的这个缩写。那这个 other 缩写就是 e 是在这个 other 缩写里边的。那这种情况呢，这个上颚的 sh 就会变成上颚的 ch。
Okay, so friends, now we will study Shashchhoti.
那我们现在来看 shashchhoti 这就经营。
The literal meaning of this sutra. Are we ready for this?
Yes。
So say all of you, Shashchhoti.
我们一起读一下，shashchhoti。
Tri Padamidam Sutram. This sutra is of Tri Pada.
shashchhoti 它是由三个词构成的。
So say all of you, Shah,
shaha。
Cha, Arti,
车哈，车阿迪，
Arti. This is the split version of the sutra.
这是把它拆开，这个就是我们这就进来拆开的样子。
If you look into the split version of the sutra, how Shah Cha Ati got converted into Shashchhoti?
车
All the
哈，
rules of Sandhi you have studied, whether you remember it or not.
这个就是这个沙哈车哈阿迪，是变成了 so change to water 沙哈车哈阿迪 change to。
Saha Chaha Adi got converted into Shastoti, changed
Shastoti，
into Shastoti.
那查哈阿底就变成 Shastoti，这个怎么变的规则，我们之前都学过了。
No, all sutra not you have studied. These are the sandhi you have not studied. Yes, I'm
哦哦，还
sorry.
有一个身体，中间有个 Visakha 身体，
Oh, you haven't studied. Yes.
有个符号的，就是有符号的这个身体，我们还学。Oh, it's
Yeah.
that's a phone. Yeah, please.
So, Saha Chaha Adi, Tri Padamidam Sutram. This sutra is of Tri Pada.
就这句经典的话，它是由三个词构成的。
So, Saha Chaha Adi, this sutra is in a code language which means Saha means of the letter Sha. Chaha means Cha.
沙哈的意思就
Third
是指。
happen. Please let me complete, Michelle.
OK。
Saha means of the letter Sha. Chaha means chaha will happen. Adi means if cha is followed with the letters of at pratyahar.
Adi means what? What is followed?
Adi means when the letters of at pratyahar are after. Cha will be changed into cha when after cha at pratyahar letter comes. When the letters of at pratyahar are after.
就是这个查哈，沙哈的意思就是上颚的沙哈的意思，就是指这个舍，上颚的舍这个字母。查哈的话就是指这个。哈，那哈就会就是，也就是说这个，什么意思呢？就是说这个舍后面跟的是阿底这个阿的这个缩这个就是缩写，就是这个上颚的舍后面后面出现的字母，它是在阿的这个缩写里的情况下，那这个上颚的舍就会变成上颚的彻。这个社会变成彻，就是这句经言要表达，就这个社会变后面的彻给替代。
老师，那意思是说，这个色哈的后面出现了阿迪，
缩写里边的字母。
对，阿迪里面的字母的话，那个第一个字就要变成第二个字就对了。
啊，对的，就是舍哈会变成恰哈，对的，就是这个意思，没错。但是前
再
期的
说一次吗？
啊什么？
再说一次好不好？
再说一次啊，再说一次，就是说，就是这个舍哈，首先这个舍哈就指牙齿的这个舍哈，对吧？这个舍哈，它其实现在讲的其实是这个叫什么？乌德巴的，我们现在讲的是乌德巴的。就是第二个词，那这个舍哈就是说是这个上颚的舍，那这个上颚的舍后面跟的是阿底这个缩写里边的字母的话，那这个舍后面是不是 e 呀？我们刚讲的那个 e 对吧？短的 e 对吧？是吧？其实他讲的就是这个短的 e，就那个短的 e 是在这个舍之后的，就是 she 嘛对吧？she 对吧？第二个词是不是 she 对吧？那这个 sh 后面是不是跟着是 e 呀、啊？短的 e 对吧？那如果 sh 后面跟的这个字母是在这个 ad 是缩写里边的话，那这个 sh 就是第一个 sh 好 sh 就会变成 ch，就变成 ch，就是这个 jch 都也是上颚的第二个 jch 你有吗？我要给大家发一个图。就是这个社，这个社就会变成社。我用那个蓝色的图标啊，蓝色的这个社就会变成车。
Can I proceed?
蓝色的标准，yes，please。
Okay, scholars. So that is Shastoti. So we will get back to the interpretation now.
那我们先来看一下这个，就是这个 这就是今天的解释，大家理解了吗？
And Michelle, we can meet tomorrow. Okay.
Tomorrow, I suggest we have one session this week because Ronghua cannot join tomorrow.
Oh, but I'm free tomorrow.
Otherwise, she's gonna miss a lot.
Yeah. Okay, no problem. So say all of you, Jaya Parasya.
我们一起来读一下：Chaya Parasya,
Yeah.
Shastya,
Shastya.
Shastya,
Chovati.
Chovati.
So, va means optionally.
Va 我们已经看到很多次了，对吧？Va 的意思就是可选择的。
Jaya, from the letters of Jaya Pratyahar, Parashya Satya, of the Sha which comes after. Cha will happen, Ati, provided that Cha is followed with the letters of At Pratyahar.
So could you just say that again? So the you mean the last letter?
Jaya means from Jaya Pratyahar.
这个 chair 的意思是指，这个来自于这个 chair 这个缩写，就刚刚我那个用红色画出来的 chair 这个缩写。
Jaya means from Jaya Pratyahar. Like for example, in Tat Shivaha, Cha is from Jaya Pratyahar.
在这个 search Shiva 号里边，这个。这是在来自于这个 Chaya's body 哈里边。
So Jaya means from Jaya Pratyahar. Parasya Sasya from Jaya Pratyahar, the Sha which comes after.
就是在这个，就是这个车是在这个这个叫什么 Chaya body 哈之后出现的。也就是说，我们刚讲的 verb 的最后一个字母是来自于这个 che 本来就是这个 che 是来自于，讲的是 verb 的啊，这个 che 是来自于这个 che 这个缩写里边的，这个叫 che 哈。
Cha will happen. Va means optionally. Ati, when that cha is followed with the letters of at pratyahar.
也就是说，这个。我们的上颚的 sh 后面跟的是 ad 这个缩写里边的字母，那这里边的字母就是指 e 短的 e，就是 shiva，就是指这个 e 是在这个 sh 的后面的，就是讲的是 udaba 的，
Is that clear?
大家清楚吗？
So say all of you, Jaya Parasya.
我们一起读一下 chaya ha balasya。Balasya means what? Balasya.
Parasya means para means after. Parasya sasya of that after sasya.
就是 Balasya 是指 Balasya，它其实是在什么什么之后，也就是在这个sha 之后，这个。
Is that okay?
对吗？
So say all of you, Jaya Parasya.
我们一起读一下。
Jaya
Jaya
Parasya.
Parasya。
Shastya Chovati.
Jas
Shastya
Chovati。
Parasya。
Yes. Okay, so that the later part of it we will cover in the next class.
那下面的部分就是我们下节课再教。那因为那个，我这个。